Welcome to my channel Today News. Please subscribe my channel for update news and get notifications from Today News.
Obamacare is hardly repealed, but some may have more and costlier insurance choices. Hours after Congress passed the tax bill Wednesday, President Trump declared the Affordable Care Act essentially repealed. In fact, it's barely touched. What was repealed effective in 2019 was the requirement that nearly everyone have insurance or pay a penalty at tax time. This is important, but it's not the heart of the ACA, by any means, says Sarah Collins, Vice President of Healthcare Coverage and Access for the nonprofit Commonwealth Fund. What the tax bill doesn't change. The federal and state exchanges that sell insurance to those who don't get it from their employers will remain open, and people who gained Medicaid coverage under the expansion of the program will be able to keep it. Subsidies will remain available if these people who make below 400% of the federal poverty limit, about $98,000 for a family of four. Most employers will still be required to offer plans that comply with the law and a variety of other requirements for insurers. Doctors and hospitals will be intact until or unless Congress or the Department of Health and Human Services, HHS, changes them by legislative or regulatory fiat. The mandate's effect was highly exaggerated because it wasn't an effective mandate to begin with, says healthcare economist Gail Wilensky, who headed the Centers for Medicare and Medicaid Services in the George H.W. Bush administration. The penalty for not having insurance was often far less than the cost of having insurance. Besides, there were too many ways people could be exempted from the requirement, says Wilensky, a senior fellow with the Global Health Foundation Project Hope. More evidence of the ACA's staying power. CMS Administrator Seema Verma tweeted Thursday that nearly 9 million people signed up for insurance during open enrollment, which ended December 5, on the federal exchange used by people in 39 states. That's 96% of the enrollment through the end of the much longer open enrollment period last year, says Lori Lodes, co-founder of the advocacy group Get Covered America. The effect of the mandate's repeal will actually be felt mostly by the very people Trump has said he was trying to help, those paying soaring premiums for their health plans. Premiums are expected to increase overall by about 10% when the mandate is repealed, largely because it may discourage healthy people from buying insurance. These people help offset the cost of health care for the sick. Collins says the effect of the increase could vary widely by state.